गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू एसएसटी क्लास। टुडे आल्सो वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर रिवीजन वर्क। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 2, फ्रॉम हंटिंग गैदरिंग टू ग्रोइंग फूड। यू हैव ऑलरेडी नोटिस्ड दैट योर एवरी चैप्टर बिगिंस विद अ क्वेश्चन, and to give the answer of that question we have to go through the chapter. Today's chapter start with Tushar's train journey and a question arises in his mind, that is when people couldn't travel quickly from one place to another, did they spend their entire life wherever they were born? Actually not quite. So let's start with the chapter. First topic is the earliest people. Why were they on the move? We know human life has evolved over millions of years. In early stages, men were hunters and food gatherers. They hunted wild animals, caught fishes, birds, and gathered fruits, nuts, seeds, roots, leaves, eggs, and many more. Earliest people lead a nomadic life. Why? Why they lead a nomadic life? There were some reasons. Number one, if they had stayed at one place, resources like plants and animals would be finished. Second reason was, plants bear different fruits in different seasons. So, men had to move in search of this fruit as per seasons. Third point was, they had to move wherever water was available. And fourth point was, animals move from place to place. So, people had to follow their movements for hunting purpose. So these are the reason for their nomadic life. Now move to our next topic. It is, how do we know about these people? Archaeologists have found several tools used by hunter-gatherers. These tools give us many information about them. Tools were generally made of stone, wood, bones, etc. Stone tools were used to cut meat, chop fruits and roots, scrap bark and hides. Hides means animals' skin. Wood was used to make hut and firewood, which was also chopped by other stone tools. Okay, now move to our next topic. Choosing a place to live in. Look at map 2 below. All the places marked with red triangles are sites. Look at here. All the places marked with red triangle. These are sites. Sites are places where remains of things were found, like tools, pots, buildings, etc. People actually prefer to live in places having some availabilities, like they lived near the sources of water, such as rivers and lakes. People tried to find places where good quality stone was easily available, as it was very important for hunting. So, at that time, people used to find the places where water and good quality stones were easily available. So, move to our next topic. It is finding out about fire. Find the Kurnool Caves on map 2. Let's go to map 2, find the Kurnool Caves. Look here, it is Kurnool Caves. traces of ash have been found here. It proved that people at that time have invented the fire. It could have been used for many purposes, like as a source of light, to roast meat, to scare away animals. Now, names and dates. Here we'll read about the three stone ages. What is stone age? The period when mostly stone tools were made is known as stone age. It is divided into three parts: Paleolithic, Mesolithic and Neolithic. Paleolithic is also known as old stone age. It extends from 2 million years ago to about 12,000 years ago. Next, Mesolithic. It is also known as Middle Stone Age, beginning about 12,000 years ago till about 10,000 years ago. Next, Neolithic or New Stone Age. It is from 10,000 years ago. Okay, so these are the stone ages and their timings. Now move to our next topic. It is a changing environment. Around 12,000 years ago, there were major changes in the climate of the world, which led to the development of grassland in many areas. This also led to an increase in the number of animals that survived on that grass. So, people start thinking about herding and rearing animals. Fishing also became important for people. Next, the beginning of farming and herding. With the development of grassland, people came to know about growing wheat, barley, rice in different parts of the subcontinent. This is how they started practicing farming. In this way, farming started. Now, herding. People also attract and then tame animals by leaving food for them near their shelters. Often, people protected these animals from attacks by other wild animals. This is how they become herders. Next, domestication. It is the process in which people grow plants and look after animals. These plants and animals were different from wild plants and animals. They generally select those plants and animals that were not prone to diseases. Amongst animals, relatively gentle animals were selected for domestication. Okay. Next, a new way of life. People had to stay in the same places for a long time for looking after the plants, watering them, for weeding, driving away animals and birds till the grain ripened. Then they start thinking of storing of the grains. They began making large clay pots or woof baskets or dug pit into the ground. Okay. Then storing animals. Animals that were reared can be used as a store of food as they provide milk and meat. That's why they were used as storing of food. Animals were used as storing of food. Next, finding out about the first farmers and herders. Now, turn to map 2. You will notice some blue square. They mark the site from where archaeologists have found evidence of early farmers and herders. Look at this blue squares. Okay, they are the places where archaeologists have found evidence of early farmers and herders. Some of them are in northwest in present day Kashmir, and some of them are in east and south India. Okay. Now, move to our next topic. Towards a settled life. Archaeologists have found traces of huts or houses at some sites, which shows that people had a stable life. They have also found cooking huts both inside and outside the huts. Stone tools have been found from many sites. They are different from Paleolithic tools. That is why they are called Neolithic. Their tools were polished with fine cutting edge, and mortars and pestles were also found. Mortars and pestles are grinding tools. Okay. Many kinds of earthen pots have been found at that time. These were used for storing things. People also began weaving clothes using different kinds of materials like cotton. Next, a closer look, living and dying in Mehergarh. Find Mehergarh on map 2. In your book, go to map 2 and find Mehergarh. This site is located in the fertile plain near the Bolan Pass, which is one of the most important routes into Iran. Mehergarh was one of the places where people learned to grow barley and wheat and rear sheep and goats for the first time in this area. At this village, many animals' bones and remains of square and rectangular houses were found. When people died, they were buried with goats, which were probably meant to serve as food in the next world. They believe in the next world. Several burial sites also have been found at Mehergarh. Okay, here we end the chapter. Now go to the exercises of this chapter. There are 2 fill in the blanks and 5 question answers. We have already done this. You have to revise the chapter and exercises thoroughly. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.